So here we are in the Q&A session. Professor Choi, we have lots of questions coming in, and we'll try to take as many questions as possible in the time. And for the rest of the questions, the attendees may contact Professor Choi via email. So I'll begin with the first question, Professor Choi, for you.
Okay.
So the question is, what are effective collection mechanisms of photocatalytic nanoparticles after contaminant degradation of water splitting applications?
Oh, how can power this semiconductor particle?
Yeah.
Well, actually, if you are working on water splitting for hydrogen generation, because the product is gas, there is no need to separate gas particle. But if you are working on a water treatment purpose, obviously you need to recover semiconductor particle. But for water treatment application, this recovering particle suspension is not very practical because separation process could be very costly. So in reality, the catalyst should be mobilized on the solid support or electrode form. So for practical application, the catalyst should be immobilized on the support. I don't think the slurry phase will be practical application for water treatment.
Yeah, thank you, Professor Choi. So one question is there from one of the attendees, Sheikh. Can you please explain when studying photoelectrocatalytic oxidation, as it splits water, oxygen, and hydrogen mm-hmm. will be produced? How can we determine amount of produced gases?
Well, actually, so we actually analyze the gas in headspace of the each cell. For example, for analyzing oxygen, so you just measure the hydrogen gas in the headspace of the anode compartment. You also analyze the hydrogen gas in the headspace of the cathode compartment. So that's a standard process procedure. So analyze the gas component in the headspace.
Thank you, Professor Choi. So the next question is, one of the attendees would like to hear from you on how to categorize a photoreaction, whether it is an electron hole separation and transfer or radical reaction.
Well, it's actually a very complex mechanism. So there is a lot of debate about whether this oxidation is in direct hole transfer reaction or radical mediated reaction. Actually, both are happening. Actually, some reactions are taking place by direct hole transfer, and some reactions are driven by OH radical or radical driven pathway. So generally, all mechanisms are mixed together. But in generally, when the substrate are strongly adsorbed on the surface, and then direct hole transfer is actually a favorable mechanism. But when the substrate is non-adsorbing, majority of degradation pathway is actually a radical mediated pathway.
So hope that answers the question. And then we have, what is your opinion regarding the scope of donor acceptor based organic porous framework materials for photoelectrocatalysis?
Yeah, I think it's possible. Yeah, I'm not a specialist on this kind of organic photocatalysis field, but I've seen this, there are many new materials are emerging in this photocatalysis field utilizing this donor acceptor type of photocatalyst. But at this moment, I think this is really quite fundamental material research stage, not very practical stage at this moment, but I think it's possible. Yes.
Thank you, Professor Choi. So we have a simple question, but from the expertise point of view, it's good to have your thoughts on that. What is the criteria for a molecule to be used as a photocatalyst?
Well, actually, there are many criteria. The absorption spectrum should match with the solar spectrum. So how absorption efficiency of the solar light. And then efficiency of the generating radical, for example, what is the efficiency of hydroxyl radical generation on the semiconductor surface is also another important criteria. And then durability is also very important criteria as well. Some materials are very effective, but very, very unstable. So it should be stable as well. And also it should be very cheap, not high cost material. So for example, noble metal containing material would not be a very practical choice because of the cost issue. So there are many many issues, many criteria you have to consider in choosing the most practical for catalyst.
Yeah. Thank you, Professor Choi, for this nice explanation. And we have the next question in how TiO2 forms radicals without H2O. What is the source for hydrogen there?
So proton and water molecule actually directly reduced by conduction band electron, and they can produce hydrogen. You need the water to produce hydrogen.
Okay, so water is really required there.
Water splitting is actually one popular method of the hydrogen production.
One of the attendees have a question like, is it possible to use the atmospheric CO2 conversion of liquid electrolyte solution for OER process?
Yeah, I think it's possible. Yeah, yeah. Basically, I think the question is actually the CO2 in the atmosphere is absorbed in the solution, and then CO2 is reduced at the same time, and water is oxidized to evolve the oxygen. Is that the question, right?
Yes, 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 Professor.
Yeah, yeah, definitely. Yeah, that's the whole goal of CO2 reduction study, actually. People try to convert the CO2 in the atmosphere to the hydrocarbon liquid fuel, like hydrocarbon. And then at the same time, water is reduced. Water is oxidized to evolve oxygen.
So we have one question. How to synthesize nanodiamonds and which is the best method to synthesize nanodiamonds?
Well, actually, I didn't synthesize nanodiamonds. I just used the commercially available nanodiamond. But frankly speaking, I don't remember how these commercial nanodiamonds were synthesized. But you can find the information pretty easily from the internet because it's commercially available.
So we can have the question as, what are the challenges for mass adaptation utilization of photocatalysts for environmental and energy applications?
Well, there are many, many, many issues, actually. The efficiency issue, they are still very low, actually. And a majority of the solar conversion efficiency are a few percent at best. Sometimes even much lower than 1%. So that's the increasing the low efficiency is number one problem.
Yeah.
And catalyst durability is also another problem, big problem, because many laboratory synthesized material is not very stable for a long time, actually. In the majority of scientific research paper, they just describe the initial, they just test the initial activity of the material. But they rarely report the long-term stability of the material. So many of the laboratory synthesized semiconductor material is not very stable for long-term use. So that's another issue, actually. And then easy availability and scale of possibility is another issue, because many sophisticated material is only synthesized small quantity in the laboratory. And then production in a large quantity is a very different problem, completely different problem, actually. So in terms of a practical application, there are tons of issues that need to be solved, right? But majority of academic research is not only focused on the material characteristic and the activity demonstration in a small scale, but for practical application, it's a whole different story, actually.
Thank you, Professor Chow. So we'll take the last question in the interest of time. So The question is, how did you overcome the problems of a smaller surface area of GC3N4 and its fast electron hole recombination?
Well, that's a big question, actually. That's a general problem in semiconductor photocatalysis, actually. So many different kind of the approaches has been developed, like all kind of different modification method, like semiconductor doping, surface complexation, or hybridization with nanomaterial is all related with how to retard the fast recombination. All bunch of material has been developed in the literature, and then but still not very satisfactory for practical purpose. Although there are many, many different methods of the modification have been developed, the overall solar energy utilization still remain only a few percent at best. So that's a big challenge we need to address, actually.